LMS, and welcome back to Buzz TV. Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. Welcome back to your school news. Today is day 6, Friday, January 28th, and these are your student announcements. Spring sorts signups for 7th and 8th grade students are due Thursday. Check out the school website for the form. 6th grade volleyball fun runs through February and March. Submit the Google form. Return the signed parent form by next Tuesday. Limited sports are available. See Ms. Blose, Mr. Scholl, or Mrs. Sicily for the parental form, and be sure to join the 6th grade volleyball Schoology group. Canes will be singing the national anthem at the Lehigh Valley Phantoms game on Saturday, March 5th. See your homeroom teacher for an order form for this fundraiser. Orders are due February 4th. The Hives is open 9th period for 7th grade today. Today's lunch is Orange Kiss Chicken Bowl, and Monday's lunch is spaghetti and meatballs. That's all from me, LMS. Now on over to your world news.
Hey there, I'm a mess. Welcome back to BuzzTV's Amazing Raffle. Now let's see our winners for this week. Our 6th grade Zing Raffle winners were Trevin and Maxwell J. Great job, both of you. 7th grade Zing Raffle winners were Chris and Aria. Great job to you both. And congratulations to our 8th grade Zing Raffle winners, Crystally and Maxwell G. Great job to you both. And finally, our Teacher Zing Raffle winner for this week was Mrs. Kleintop. You did a great job and keep up the great work. If you were a winner this week, stop down to room 304, the FCS room, to collect your gift card. Now we have an amazing weekend on the mess. Goodbye.
Hey, LMS, it's Clara with your world news. What could have been a very frightening situation turned into a cute one for an animal shelter in Pennsylvania. The Bedford County Humane Society on Tuesday told a local station, WTAG, that one of its dogs, Gillian, a longtime shelter resident, got loose from his kennel overnight after it had accidentally been left unlocked. Instead of making a major mess or getting lost or hurt, the animal had a much more adorable idea in mind, playing with all the shelter's various squeaky toys. Gillian had a very specific playtime agenda in mind once he got out of his kennel. He had seemingly taken all the shelter's non-squeaker toys and put them to the side while he played with all the squeaky ones, which the employees found strewn across multiple hallways. Isn't this a great story, LMS? Well, let's head over to your weather news update. Hey LMS, it's Clara with your weather news update. Today is going to be a high of 34 with a low of 17, and there's going to be a 30% chance of snow after 3 p.m. Tomorrow's there's going to be a high of 22 and a low of 9 with a 50% chance of snow, 1 to 2 inches possible. I hope you have a great day. Let's head over to your sports news update. Macaroni, spaghetti, meatballs. No! Good morning, LMS. It's Ella bringing you your sports news. Starting off with school sports, the girls' basketball team has a home game today against Springhouse. The boys also have a home game Monday against Springhouse, so make sure to come share your support. Now heading over to your main story. Just 2 days ago marks the passing of basketball superstar Kobe Bryant as well as his daughter Gianna. In honor of them, a gold statue of Kobe and Gianna was placed on the site where the helicopter crashed. The statue marking the 2-year anniversary of their deaths was made by sculptor Dan Medina. Carried up the hill to the site by Medina at 4 a.m. Wednesday, the 160-pound statue will remain there temporarily. This piece of art shows Kobe wearing his Lakers jersey with his arm around Gianna, who is also wearing a basketball jersey. What do you think about this memorial statue, LMS? Well, that's all for me now. Let's head on over to your entertainment news.
Good morning, LMMS. Sami here with your entertainment news. Amazon's delivery drones were supposed to be in full flight by now. In 2013, the online retailer announced an experimental drone delivery service. Packages containing anything from toothpaste to a new smartphone would arrive at your front door by drone. The drone would land, drop your package, and fly away. Amazon founder Jeff Bezos said that in time that the service would take 4 or 5 years to develop, but it's been a little more than 8 years. The company is struggling to make progress. Amazon is committed to making our goals of delivering packages by drones a reality, the company said last year. But Amazon added, it will continue to take time. Widespread drone delivery could have a huge impact. Drones have the potential to be even more efficient and environmentally friendly than electric delivery vans. But as Amazon's struggles show, there are plenty of challenges. These include the need for more warehouses and concerns about airspace safety. So, LMMS, how would you feel if a drone showed up to your doorstep with a new laptop or your new books? That's all for me. Now on to 2022 hopes and predictions.
Our prediction is the woolly mammoth is going to come back to life.
The world won't end.
I think I'm going to have to repeat this year. No, I think I have to go to summer school too. Anyways.
I hope that there's not another COVID outbreak.
I'm going to high school this year.
Oh, Kanye for president, 2022.
What?
Kanye for president.
That's not the last.
Thanks for watching LMMS. Tune in tomorrow and have a great rest of your day.